Hey guys, welcome to another tutorial of WP Create. The tutorial is sponsored by Variation Searches for WooCommerce plugin by Imran Hamid. At the time of my recording, it had more than 200,000 active installations and plenty of 5-star rating. The plugin converts WooCommerce Variation Select dropdown into color, image, button, and radio swatches. Find the plugin download link in the description box. To download more WooCommerce plugin, please visit storepress.com. Today I'm going to show you how to customize your WooCommerce product page using UX Builder. So without any further delay, let's get into the video. So this is my WooCommerce product page, which I'll be customizing later on. Before heading to the product page customization, let's select a product layout page that I will customize in this tutorial. For demonstration purpose, I have selected left column product page layout from the Flatsome official demo. The process of customization will be similar for every layout. If you want to customize your product page without manually building page elements in UX Builder, you need to go to the Flatsome official documentation page and search for shortcodes for custom product page layout. In this documentation page, we have added shortcodes for all available product page layouts so that you can choose your desired shortcode and start customizing in the UX Builder. As I am going to customize the left sidebar layout, so I am copying the shortcodes for this layout and creating a new block from UX blocks with my desired title. Now we need to paste the shortcode here and hit to the publish button for publishing this block. Now from product page, navigate to product layout and select custom product layout and choose your newly created block from custom product layout drop down and publish it. To start customizing the product page layout, first you need to go to any of the product pages and click on edit product layout with UX Builder. Here is the block that I created using the shortcodes. From here, you can drag and drop elements to your desired location to reorder the elements, add elements as per your requirements, and also can change the settings from the elements options. Once you've finished with adding or rearranging elements, hit the update button and go to the product page to see the changes. That's all for today. Don't forget to subscribe and stay connected. If you have any query, please write down in the comment section. Thank you.